How to repair random crashes on MacBooks. This is when you receive a gray screen crash notification. A MacBook kernel, the lowest level of the operating system, will force shut down a MacBook if it feels like there might be permanent damage that's imminent. In this video, we'll cover why Macs crash, how to fix graphics processor unit crashes, how to fix other crashes, and how to permanently fix persistent crashes. MacBooks have a lot of sensors. Just like in the following example, after randomly opening up a window, the computer crashed and showed the following crash notification. This is common with MacBooks, and the reason why this happens is to prevent your computer from permanently damaging itself. After seeing this notification, the MacBook will most likely restart itself. After the restart, log yourself in. On the window that pops up after you log in, what you want to do is you want to click on the report button and then click show details. This will give you a report, and in the first paragraph you can determine what exactly was the reason that caused the crash to happen. There's a lot of data and it looks a little confusing, but at the end of the first paragraph, on the last line, you can see a caller. In this particular instance, it's a GPU panic. That means the graphics processing unit failed. More than half of gray screen crashes happen on MacBooks with dual graphics cards. When the integrated card attempts to switch to the dedicated card, the system has an error and crashes. There's a workaround for this, but please note that this is by far not a permanent solution. A total permanent solution can be achieved through the Apple's repair program for any MacBook that's between 2011 and 2013. This can be done at any Apple service store for free. Here's a temporary workaround. Open up Safari and navigate to appledollars.com. Once at appledollars.com, click on Downloads. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and click Disable Second GPU Download. Once this is downloaded, go ahead and open your Downloads folder and drag the GFX card status into the Applications folder. Once in the Applications folder, go ahead and open it. Once running, it'll show up as an icon in the top right of the screen. Click on the icon and select Integrated Graphics. You should see it switch from N to I. Click the Apple logo and go to About This Mac. Here you'll see that the graphics now is the Intel integrated one. You can now test out your system and play some HD content from a site like YouTube. This will allow you to test it and make sure that you're not crashing. Because the integrated graphics card is locked in, it shouldn't have any problem switching between the integrated and the other GPU. Click on the eye and go to Preferences. Make sure to select Load GFX Card Status at Startup. Use smart menu icons as well. Other gray screen crashes can be fixed by repairing disk permissions and resetting the system management controller. Go to Go and go to Utilities. In the Utilities folder, open up Disk Utility. Select your main operating system hard disk and click First Aid. Click Run. This will repair any disk permission issues. Disk permission issues cause operating system failure. Other programs can modify your disk permission without your knowledge. This will fix that issue. This should be done with a combination of resetting the system management controller. Open up Safari and navigate to appledollars.com. Once at appledollars.com, click Troubleshooting. Scroll over and find Reset SMC. watch this video on how to reset your system management controller. This is a remedy to about 20 different crash problems. Of course, the only true way to fix permanent persistent system crashes is to replace the logic board. You can easily find out how to do this by clicking the Apple logo, going to About This Mac, and figuring out what MacBook year and size that you have. Once you have this information, go ahead and navigate to appledollars.com. Once at appledollars.com, you can select MacBooks from the home page. Select your MacBook size and select your MacBook year. On the interactive how-to video map, find the logic boards. Go ahead and click the logic board video. In the very beginning of the video, you'll find the part number to your logic board and the tools that you'll need for the repair. This concludes our system crash repair video. Thank you for watching.